All right, guys, we're going to be looking at the knees over toes split squat, why it can help you build good quads and avoid knee pain. For many years, the knees over toes position, the excess dorsiflexion and knee flexion, was deemed to be a really bad position, attributing to more knee pain and dysfunctions in the body. Full range of motion exercises have proven to be the king of all. Taking joints through a full range will keep them healthier much longer. Looking at a full range of motion squat, we do need an adequate amount of ankle mobility in terms of dorsiflexion, a high degree of knee flexion, and also we do require an adequate amount of hip mobility. So when looking to achieve and maintain that full range of motion with the squat, we're not looking at continuously stretching or mobilizing them. We want to get into that position as often as possible. The knees over toes split squat is one of the best ways to do that. Easily performed with a barbell on the back, a kettlebell front racked, dumbbells at your side, or any other creative way you can think of. When looking at the position at the bottom of this movement, we're trying to really isolate as much as we can the quad, almost in a way that might be hard to do bilaterally. So setting this one up, stand in your split stance, maybe a little bit wider, and try to keep your back leg fairly fixed. You don't want to be bending that back knee too much, just to allow the forward movements of this exercise. Unlike a normal split squat, we're not going up and down, we're trying to squat forward and try to keep all that tension on the quad. For beginners, try to keep your heel down as much as you can. If you're a little bit more advanced, you can actually start training that position where you go on the front of your foot. This would only be recommended if you have zero issues with your knees and you know what you're doing. Make sure you have the adequate amount of mobility in the ankle first. We need dorsiflexion to do this safely. In retrospect, we need to train this position as much as possible. Athletes do get into this position very often in the sport, and we want to be ready for it and not jump into it unexpectedly, thus leading to injury. Everyday people can always benefit from more dorsiflexion, allowing them greater range of motion with any lower body exercise. This one does allow you to hit different parts of your quad a little bit more than a bilateral squat or a normal split squat. One of them being your vastus medialis or your VMO, which is one of the most important muscles in terms of knee health. Give this one a try in your program, and I'll see you guys in the next one.